Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is all inspired by International Women's Day, and we are going to talk about some just incredible fucking women that I follow on Instagram or on YouTube or whatever. Now I just want to say not every single person I follow that is a woman is in this video. However, I did throw a lot in here, and they're all just amazing. So no shade to like anyone else or anything like that. It's just through some that would bring some light to your feed. And yeah, let's just go ahead and get started. Okay, I'm not gonna do these in any particular order, but let's just get started. So first we've got Oak and Feather Decor, which is run by Leslie. Super unique designs. I mean, it's all woodwork and a little bit of like hand painted script and stuff, maybe some other things that I just don't know about or something, but I just absolutely love her work. I can't wait to actually buy a piece from her. You know, running low on the cash flow these days, but oh well. Next up we've got Art of the Overshare, which is Sarah. She just seems super entertaining. I like watch all of her stories. Yeah, I don't know. She just seems super entertaining. I really love her makeup looks, but she, I mean, doesn't always do them. But yeah, go check her out. Next up, we have Lights Lacquer, or Lacquer? Lacquer? Light Lacquer? Fuck. Which is run by Kathleen Lights. It's her second nail polish company, because the first one, a whole bunch of stuff with that. But it's my absolute favorite polish. It's literally the only polish that I currently use. I love the unique shades and the super clever names, and she always does like a black and white photo when she's making a new launch with just like the bottom of the bottles that have the shade names, and we all get to figure out like what shade it could be. So yeah, go follow them. Kind Matter Company. They are a local shop that does all ethical household items and just like everything, and it's just incredible, and you should go follow them to get some inspo to help save the planet. Next up we have Made for the Lake, and they have just super cozy wear and just super cozy cottage wear. That is the better way to explain it. Next up, we've got Raw Beauty Christie. I feel like a lot of you might know her, which is like amazing, but she seems super down to earth. She's very chatty. She's always on the Instagram stories giving you life updates and everything, which is incredible. You feel more connected to the person that you're watching on YouTube, which is always nice. Next up, we have Sam Ravendahl. I just love her because she's so educational. She, in all of her videos, like even the brow one, which if you've seen, I've followed sort of. If you watch her video though, she's so particular on her wording with everything to make sure even if you're brand new to doing your eyebrows, you know exactly how to do them, and she's just incredible. Next up, Julia Adams. I love her because her looks are so wearable. They're so creative but so wearable for day-to-day looks, and I love that, and she is amazing with color as well, so that's great. Next up we have Northwood Supply, which is another woodworking company. Again, unique designs, different from Oak and Feather Decor. They just have dope ass stuff. Next up is Ellie Morris. She has like cutesy little graphic pictures with words and sayings and stuff. I just love them. They just make me happy just looking at her very unique retro work. I don't know. I just love it. Casey Holmes. She is just a boss. She's just got so much going on. She's got YouTube. She's got her boutique. She's a mom. I'm sure she's got some other stuff under her everything. She's just incredible. And that's why I watch her, just because she's an inspiration to me, honestly. Next up, Sarah McGonigal. Out of this world work, man. Honestly, fucking out of this world. She does like whole scenes. She'll design a whole scene. Oh my god, it's just incredible. If you want to see someone actually put work into what they do, oh my god, it's just amazing. It's just mind-blowing. I would love to meet her and just pick her brain about things, you know? Oh god, it would just be crazy. Oh, crazy. Next up, we have Kate Marks. Her looks are just so crazy colorful, and honestly we wish we would be able to work with that. Like, any one of us wishes that was possible, but it's not, so you can just live vicariously through her. Next up, we have Loop. She just does these like recreations of actors, Hollywood stars, like TV show cartoon characters and stuff. Oh god, I love it. I've been following her for a while now. Yeah, she's just great. All of this is going to sound extremely repetitive. Next up, we have Molly. Honestly, you could follow her for her facial features and that's it, and you would be happy. You would be satisfied following her. But I just love the way that she plays on her facial features. Like, she knows exactly where to place everything. Ugh. I wish. Sammy. She's just got this incredible rocker style. I love her wearable makeup, but like, her style is where it's at. She does head scarves right now. Wish I could get some. I just wish. But again, on that low cash flow life right now. Next up, we have Vanessa. She just... insane prosthetics. She does hours and hours on one look. Just insane. Honestly, just insane. Just look. Just insane. And last but not least, we have Caroline. And she does florals all over her eyes, and it's just aesthetically pleasing to us all. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope this wasn't so incredibly repetitive or anything, but I highly suggest you check everyone out, if not just one person. I think you would be very satisfied seeing them on your feeds. But yes, thank you so much for watching, guys, and I will see you in the next video.